Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. You came to gather the nations into the peace of God's kingdom. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You come in word and sacrament to strengthen us in holiness. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You will come again in glory with salvation for your people. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God on the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Graciously hear our supplications, O Lord, so that we who believe that the Savior of the human race is with you in your glory may experience, as he promised until the end of the world, his abiding presence among us. Who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Would you please be seated for the readings. A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Peter stood up in the midst of the brothers. There was a group of about 120 persons in the one place. He said, "My brothers, the scripture had to be fulfilled which the Holy Spirit spoke beforehand through the mouth of David concerning Judas, who was the guide for those who arrested Jesus. He was numbered among us and was allotted a share in this ministry. For it is written in the book of Psalms, 'May another take his office.' Therefore it is necessary that one of the men who accompanied us the whole time the Lord Jesus came and went among us, beginning from the baptism of John until the day in which he was taken up from us, becomes with us a witness to his resurrection." So they proposed two, Judas called Barsabbas, who was also known as Eustace, and Matthias. Then they prayed, "You, Lord, who know the hearts of all, show which one of these two you have chosen to take the place in his apostolic ministry, from which Judas turned away to go to his own place." Then they gave them lots, and the lot fell upon Matthias, and he was counted with the 11 apostles. The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
reading from the first letter of St. John. Beloved, if God so loved us, we also must love one another. No one has ever seen God, yet if we love one another, God remains in us, and his love is brought to perfection in us. This is how we know that we remain in him, and he in us, that he has given us of his Spirit. Moreover, we have seen and testified that the Father sent his Son as Savior of the world. Whoever acknowledges that Jesus is the Son of God, God remains in him, and he in God. We have come to know and to believe in the love God has for us. God is love, and whoever remains in love remains in God, and God in him. The word of the Lord.
Good afternoon again, everyone. Remember me, I was the guy that was just up there? I want to extend that special welcome to you all again today on this holy day, the day in which your children receive their very first Holy Communion. And as much as at Mass when we preach, we speak to everybody, today in particular, I'd like to speak more to your kids. So please humor me as I speak a little bit more to them in their situation today. Kids, today's an awesome day, and there really isn't much of a better word for it. We throw the word awesome around pretty easily, like, ooh, hot dogs, awesome. Socks, awesome. No school, awesome. The problem is that we get used to saying that word so much that when the truly awesome moments happen, the word just doesn't seem to fit. It's almost like we need something more. So on today like today, I think it's worth remembering just what that word is all about. To be so filled with awe, for our hearts to flutter, for our minds to race, for our knees to shake, for all that we are to be a little bit more elevated than usual, because something special is happening today.
something special that you have yet to experience in your lives, something that you've been preparing for, something your parents and your family has been wanting for you for all these years. And after so much time waiting, after so much time preparing, it finally gets to happen. The day you receive Jesus in the Eucharist. Since before you were born, Jesus was waiting for this moment. This moment he's able to give all of his love, all of his heart, all of his life to you, to be kept safe, to be enjoyed, to be experienced, to be treasured. Jesus has been waiting to give you this great gift. And it's one that you better be excited to receive, because this ain't any old gift. This is a gift from God himself, and he's good at giving gifts. Today in the gospel, when Jesus speaks to you, he's praying with his disciples before he goes to his cross, before he gets ready to be crucified, before he rises from the dead. And the only thing on his mind throughout all of this is praying for you. Praying that you always stay close to him, to his church, in your prayer, in your good works, and the love that you share. As St. John told us today, those who love God have God's life in them. God stays close to those who stay close to him. When you receive Holy Communion, Jesus is closer to you than he's ever been before. When you came into this church slightly smaller than you are right now, you were baptized. Jesus came to your world and into your life and wanted to share his grace with you. He has been waiting all these years to bring you to the next step in your friendship with him. To be so close to him that you know he is always near, how much you can rely on, how much he has planned for you, how many good things he's going to accomplish in your life. That's pretty awesome. But there's a catch. All of this will happen if, and only if, you decide to love him back. If you stay close to him, as he's looking to be very close to you. Imagine for a second that you had a friend. You never talked to this friend. You never got any presents from this friend. You never visited this friend. You don't even know what your friend looks like. Can you really call him your friend? No. Your friends are the people that you see all the time. Even during a pandemic, we have found ways to be close to our friends. They're the people you're excited to be around. The people you can't wait to tell things to. The people you can't wait to hear things about. The people who, when you're sad, try to make you happy. The people, when you're happy, try to make you even happier. The people who give you wonderful gifts, not just in stuff, but in your friendships. The people you can rely on all the time, no matter how tough things are or how easy they are. Your friends stay close to you. That's how they stay your friends. And if you decided one day to your closest friend, I'm not going to talk to you anymore. I'm not going to visit you anymore. I'm not going to buy you any nice presents anymore. I'm not going to even acknowledge where you come from. You've made a decision to stop being somebody's friend. And when friendships are broken, it really hurts. Every one of us has had situations like that. We've all felt it in some way. That's what the apostles felt when they talked about Judas.
someone they considered very close to them, who decided instead to go his own way and break their friendship off. But the apostles knew that they needed something more than a broken heart. They needed to know they could count on each other. And the way they knew they could count on each other was finding someone who was like them. Someone who believed like them. Someone who loved like them. Someone who helped like them. Someone so much like what they were looking for that they were able to welcome them in and stay close. See, that's what Jesus offers you today. A chance to be so close to him as to be counted as one of his friends for all of time. No matter how old you get, no matter how tall you get, no matter how grumpy you get, Jesus doesn't stop wanting to show you all the wonderful things in his life, all the good things he has planned for you and yours. He never wants to stop giving you the good things that you both want and need. And so he prays to his heavenly Father that you and he may be one. Not divided, not separate from each other, but to live so close that you look almost like the same person. You share the same thoughts. You share the same loves. You share the same experiences. You share the same hopes. Jesus wants to count you as one of them. Because that's what he says he and his heavenly Father are. They're one and the same. They love the same. They hope the same. They give the same. He wants you to be as close to him as he is to God the Father and God the Holy Spirit. And that is awesome. He doesn't want to just know you for a couple of days and then not talk to you anymore. He doesn't want to invest in you for a few years and then stop bothering with you. He wants for all of your life to be as close as possible so that you are always as close as possible to him. And so on your first Holy Communion day, you receive a wonderful gift. Be happy. Gifts like this don't come around every day. They do come every Sunday, though. It's an opportunity to refresh that love we have. Because if love isn't kept fresh, it starts to stink. It starts to dry out. It starts to hurt. The way that we keep our love fresh with God is by always staying close to him. And so Jesus makes you a promise. Promises to be with you every single day for all of your lives and even into the life to come. And all he asks in return is that you love him now. You love him enough to talk to him, to stay with him, to pray with him, to grow with him. It's not a bad exchange. As you receive Holy Communion today, would you come forward for that host? When you go to say the word Amen, I want you to know what that word means. It's a funny word that we use in church. You don't even really use it in many other contexts. The word Amen basically means, I believe that. I want that. That is what I'm looking for. So when Jesus gives you this great gift, when you respond, Amen, you're saying back to him, I do love him. I hope to always to be close to. I hope that you will always love me. I hope that no matter where I am, you may always find me. And I promise you that I will do the same for you. And that is impossible. So there's nothing more to say than this. It's fabulous. Congratulations to you on this holy day. It is a wonderful sight in our own eyes. And we beam with pride seeing what your kids are growing into. Together in prayer, we hope to see the great things still that God has in store for them. And together as one, we march bravely forward into that life. So congratulations to you all. God bless you. And most important, God love you. Now, dear friends, I invite you please to stand as we together profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men, for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. And I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Confident in the steadfast love and care of Almighty God, let us bring our prayers and our needs before him. For the Holy Church spread throughout the world, that her members may flourish in holiness as they give witness to the glory of the risen Lord, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all government leaders, particularly our own, that the Holy Spirit may inspire them in living by the truth and working for the justice of all. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of those serving our country in the military, that they may be protected by God's watch over them, and they may return safely to their families. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who struggle in life because of poverty, sickness, or violence, that they may find comfort, hope, and support, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our parish, especially our children who make their first communion this day, the Lord may bless them so that they may continue to grow in faith and love under the guidance of the Holy Spirit, that he may fortify their families in his grace. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for all of our beloved dead, that they may know the fullness of life in the risen Christ, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord God, Heavenly Father, you comfort our hearts with the knowledge that your Son prays for us. With hope now in our hearts, we join our prayers to his, knowing that you will hear them and answer them always according to your gracious will. For we make them through the same Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Invite you please to be seated for the preparation of the altar. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty God.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the glory of his holy church.
Accept, O Lord, the prayers of your faithful with the sacrificial offerings, that through these acts of devotedness we may pass over to the glory of heaven. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just. Our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For the Lord Jesus, the King of glory, the conqueror of sin and death, ascended to the highest heavens as the angels gazed in wonder. Mediator between God and man, judge of the world and Lord of hosts, he ascended, not to distance himself from our lowly state, but that we, his members, might be confident of following where he, our head and founder, has gone before. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. If I took this time, please, to kneel. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one Spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may attain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with St. Edward the Confessor, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Frank, our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, and through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Invite you please to stand. And at the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter into my room, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you. us pray. Hear us, O God, our Savior, and grant us confidence that through these sacred mysteries there will be accomplished in the body of the whole Church what has already come to pass in Christ her Lord, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Together we pray, Saint Michael
the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly hosts, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl about the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen.